if you rush for that immortal right away. And like you said, just looking at the income tab, even though the worker count is so much lower for the little one, he's still keeping up in his, you know, economy. He has a queen over there, got to be producing extra larvae. And like you said, a bunch of zerglings, and he's killing these rocks. And so the zergling, the mass zergling, is fairly strong against these immortals. It does make the immortals practically worthless. I don't think, do we see any roaches at all? No, we don't. 51 no. Zerglings. So this is going to be, it could very well be a quick game, because either your zerglings are going to work really well, or it's going to backfire and you're going to get steamrolled. So that's what we're going to wait to see if it happens.
It's important to note that the little one actually threw up a baneling's nest, but it seems like he canceled it now. So I almost thought for a second he was going to go for a baneling bust against a Protoss player, but it looks like he has canceled the baneling's nest upon seeing the observer from Whitera get into his base. But it is so unusual to see 51 zerglings out this early on in the game. I mean, these zerglings aren't doing anything. They could have been drones that would have really propelled the little one into having a much stronger economy, and it looks like now he's transitioning into roaches, getting that glial reconstitution, which is speed for the roaches. And I don't think Whitera is aware of the fact that this gold, yeah, now he's getting observer into the gold, so he knows that he is getting really out macroed at this point. Now the rocks have been exposed towards the north, and he is starting to push out with this army. And you said that zerglings are pretty good against immortals. The other thing to consider is the sentries, which are very good at blocking zerglings. But look at this, the zerglings coming into the front door of Whitera. Whitera needs to get over there and do something. He can't allow his front door to get breached right now.
Absolutely, but look at that building placement. Only a couple zerglings per building can actually attack there. Force field trapping quite a few. Those zerglings need to try and get out of there, but they are going to get sandwiched here. Look at that, oh! The force field going to block every single zergling. I mean, there's about three or four that are going to get away. Talk about crazy good micro there. I mean, how hard is it to block off zerglings with that, because they are so small and fast. And although one thing to know is TLO is actually getting one zergling in here, not only to harass the workers, but to scout. But now the pressure is on. This is what I'm talking about, is these zerglings can backfire, so you got to be careful. But the macro still in the little one's favor, and he's got to try and I guess just run right by into the main. So now Whitera's got to be very careful here, but he has a very scary force.
He does have a scary force, but at the same time, he needs to be careful about this zergling run by. This is extremely threatening. If you're a Protoss player, you move out with your ball, you leave your mineral line exposed, and good play by Whitera, leaving three zealots in his mineral line. Meanwhile, a huge force moving across the map, starting to encroach into the zerg player's main, and I'm not sure if the little one has enough forces to deal with this. That is so many immortals. Oh, this could be really bad for the little one, as that force is just so threatening, so damaging to those roaches. And oh, this is going to be horrible for the little one. I think this could be a very early GG.
Absolutely. The little one did do a really good sandwich there with the few remaining units he had. He has done some damage to the economy of Whitera. I mean, if we look at the income tab, Whitera is very, very low right now. So if the little one can somehow muster up enough forces, get his drones out of there, maybe he can be okay. But so far, three immortals inside his main base. All he has is some zergings. Is he actually going to clean this up? The drones are going to town on these immortals. The queen is pissed. She is slapping them around. Is it going to be enough? This is such a close battle here. I'm actually not sure who is going to win it. I think there may be too many drone kills, as the little one able to finally clean that up. But if we look at the units lost, the little one actually in an okay position, but the income though for Whitera is very, very strong, and the little one lost so many drones, but he still has the high yield, so this is still anyone's game. I can't believe he held that off. The income's almost identical. He is going to run in some zerglings here, although there is about four or five zealots going to be able to hold that off. This game is extreme.
This game is indeed getting extreme, as both players trading huge blows into the economy. But like you said, even though the little one is down in drone count, he's got the high yield. So that's something to definitely consider. I would even consider both players about even, perhaps even looking at the income tab, Whitera a bit lower, because his probes are getting so distracted by this renegade force of zerglings that it's just continuing to maraud his main. And look at this, more zerglings flooding in. It looks like the little one is just focusing all his production into zerglings. He's got two drones right now being produced, but he's basically been massing zerglings ever since that last attack, because he wants to go pretty much all in and try to destroy Whitera right now. He knows Whitera's forces have been decimated since the last attack, and so he's trying to stop that probe count from harvesting, and he's doing a great job at it, as the probe's finally trying to able to get back to work. And Whitera's forces are very, very small right now, only three zealots and a stalker.
But there are four roaches moving out across the map. That is huge right now. What is this Zealot doing? I don't know if he's scouting in the center of the map. He just got taken out. White Rock cannot afford to lose units right now. And so these four roaches, though. White Rock actually GG's.
Oh.
Wow. The little one able to win that. I was going to say the roaches could end this game because there's nothing to stop that. So the little one able to actually take game number one when I thought for sure he was going to lose, but such a smart choice there. He knew that White Rock wasn't going to have the base to continue macroing up like that. And so he just mass-produced Zerglings, even though he had almost no drones. Wow, game number one actually going to the little one.
That was definitely an awesome game. I cannot believe that Whitera was able to, I mean, I thought he was definitely going to win the game, and I can't believe that the little one was able to just come back using pure speedlings to basically flank from behind and take Whitera out and pretty much end the game. I mean, I think that gold expansion just meant so, so much for the little one holding on to that.
Oh, that was such a brilliant play there. I don't think Whitera expected that at all. He did scout it out with the observer, realized he was behind. He was forced to move out because the only way for him to catch up at that point was not only to take a gold expansion himself, but to also probably take his natural. That wasn't a reasonable choice. He moved out, but the control from the little one, even getting his drones in on the action, just barely able to hold that off, and then he just mass-produced the speedling to harass the economy. Great game sense there. Oh, excuse me. Great game sense there, though, by the little one. Absolutely crazy. So let's go ahead and get our second game lined up here. It should be Scrap Station, I believe. So I
right.
can't
I'm
wait.
Just, I'm having a little bit of trouble making a map on Scrap Station, and apparently I can't create a game. Do you want to try that, Husky?
You'll have to give me leader, which I think you can do.
Right.
There we go. Now. Okay, so let's see if I can go ahead and make it, as game number two is going to be on Scrap Station. It's saying, yeah, that there's, I think there's too many people. Let's see.